it's not always just the good along with it. When used as an adjective, blessed means made holy, consecrated. Well, that doesn't actually sound too bad. Until you start to give thought about what does it mean to be made holy. And when you start processing the thoughts of what does it take to become holy, I can think of some pretty scary events. When used as a noun, as it is in the Sermon on the Mount, it means those who live with God. And according to the dictionary, those who live with God in heaven. The Gospel of Matthew tells us that Jesus starts off his ministry by delivering 9 blessed are you declaratives to his disciples and a crowd that has gathered. The 9 statements are then expanded over the next few chapters depicting Jesus' ministry with the stories of giving to the needy, the need for prayer, storing your treasures in heaven, do not worry, the judging of others, and many other stories. Now, the Beatitudes can easily be read and understood as a list of requirements, much like we do with the 10 Commandments. And when viewed in this manner, it becomes very cumbersome, if not defeating. And it lends itself to understanding the Beatitudes as a list of things that we must do to get into heaven. And if this is how we understand the Beatitudes, then we are truly missing the point of what Jesus is saying to us. Remember the phrase in the prayer that we use each week, on earth as it is in heaven, in the Lord's Prayer. In that prayer, Jesus was asking that the life in God's kingdom be reflected here on earth as well. A beatitude, then, is a depiction of as to the way that we live God's kingdom here on earth. Blessed is a state of being. The action of blessed comes in the act of blessing. And I think it's hard to talk about one without discussing and addressing the other as well. In reading stories that we find in the Hebrew scriptures, we find the common theme of passing on blessings to others, generally from the father to the son. It is in receiving the blessing that one receives the inheritance. And we still pass on blessings today. When someone is being baptized, we are including them in the family of faith with a blessing. When a building becomes the home for a congregation, we bless that building. When we commission our leadership and of our church or ordaining and installing of a new pastor, we give a blessing. In these blessings, we are passing on an inheritance of God's will, of God's power, and of God's desires. So this past year has been especially a trying time for you as a congregation. As you have entered a time of wilderness experience with the loss of former pastor Bill Wasner, recognize that wilderness times are also a blessing. During this wilderness time, as a faith community, you were asked to take an active role in visioning the future of your ministry through the Crossroads workshops. Through those workshops, a vision was mapped out and commitments were made to work those plans. It has been 4 months since we started our intentional work of reshaping our ministry and intentional growth. The vision that has come out of those workshops is very basic. a desire for more spiritual growth, a focus on increasing attendance, intentional outreach to the larger community, and a focus on attracting younger families. And I must say, seeing Will in here in the mornings is a breath of fresh air. It is truly a blessing for us. All four of these areas of ministry create blessing to the larger community and to ourselves. But it takes continual action by everybody in the congregation for these blessings to come into fruition. So some of the first questions asked at the Crossroads workshops were, what gives us energy? Where do we laugh and play? Where do we see the Spirit within our congregational life? These questions allowed us to realize the blessings that we currently have. By the end of the process, those present found energy to deal with the uncertainty of tomorrow by realizing how blessed we are right now as a faith community. Recognition of being blessed helps lessen the fears of the unknown of the future. How are we blessed as a faith community? Well, let me share just a few of them with you. I'm going to have to pass over the first one because Jackie hasn't spoken with you yet. But she'll let you know. We are blessed in spirit through laughter and play in our gatherings and fellowship. People like Bob Brewster bring blessings to these events. We are blessed with music through the praise team, the choir, the second service, and a variety of people who share their musical talents. I receive a blessing each week when I hear Delana singing out in amongst the congregation. We are blessed with leadership, such as our moderator, Tom Besoff, the council, operations team, the deacons, the hospitality committee, and our missions committee, as well as all of you who do all of these little things that are behind the scenes that we do not see. The artwork in the sanctuary brings blessings, as do our lifting up prayers for a variety of people. We are blessed because of the outreach that we do through Palmetto House, the sunrise service that happens out on the beach, the Young Women's Pregnancy Center, Spruce Creek Elementary School Projects, Boggy Creek, the thrift store, and there are many, many other mission outreaches that we are involved in. Those who take advantage of attending the special worship services that are presented throughout the year, as well as our small group gatherings, such as the Spiritual Life Group, the Adult Sunday School, the youth program, all provide a sense of being blessed. Even the staff, both paid and unpaid, bring blessing to our faith community as well. Beloved, we at Fort Orange UCC are truly blessed. We are blessed with ministries that too often we forget that we are involved in. I am sure that there are many more areas that I have not mentioned about what we do. And I'm inviting you at this time to speak aloud the ministries that give you energy, the space to laugh and to play, and feel the spirit that moves amongst our midst. So just pop out a few things that do this for you. Choir.
Thrift store.
Thrift store.
Fellowship dinner.
Fellowship dinner.
Working with you.
Working with you. I'm sorry.
Mr. Tom,
when he plays. Jesus says, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Blessed are the merciful. Blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are the peacemakers. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake. Blessed are you when people revile you on my account. Over the next few weeks, we are going to explore in depth what each of these blessed are entails and how we can live them out as a faith-filled community. Blessed is Court Orange United Church of Christ as we continue to lift God first in our lives when we do justice and when we extend love. This is the time, my friends, to celebrate who we are, a people of God, to celebrate our living into the Beatitudes that help build